Hi guys! One day during my almost daily morning walks in the park, I saw these people doing these exercises with whips. They're going like this, and they were in the grass, and I was walking along this outer sidewalk, I guess. So I took pictures of them with my phone, not thinking much of it at the time. But anyway, one of those pictures became the drawing that I'm going to show you in this video. I call it Whipping in the Park. It's 11 by 14 graphite on Strathmore 400 series drawing paper. And as always, you'll see the completed version of it at the end of the time-lapse portion of this video. Unlike most of my drawings, I didn't put a lot of detail in these people's faces, as I wanted to create the feeling of distance. I was careful to leave some areas white for highlight. As always, you can find each part explained in detail in the accompanying blog post. Honestly, when I first took this photo, I didn't know if it would be a drawing. However, at the time, I didn't know what else to draw slash paint, and this is available, so I drew it. This just goes to show that sometimes you're just to have something to draw, pieces can turn out to be pieces you're pretty proud of. I would like to point out that it's not shameful to draw or paint something that you're not really passionate about, just so you're drawing or painting. As Lisa Klaus said, as artists, we need to constantly create, and we're not always going to have something that we're really passionate about. But sometimes, if you start working on something, you might find yourself become passionate about it during the process. I definitely found that to be the case for me with this drawing. I didn't actually use a ruler for the gateposts, because sometimes I find it actually confuses things. I just drew lines very quickly to make them as straight as possible. In the spirit of creating fuzziness, you might have noticed that I didn't even give the man a knock. To be honest, I was actually a little scared when I heard the sound these whips make. It literally sounded like something snapping. I used my 9B pencil, not my 9B shading stick, my 9B pencil, for the first time in this drawing, and that was while working on the lamppost. I might have mentioned this before, but I want to point out again, it's important to use a pencil that approximates the darkness of the area that you're working on, I guess is the best way you can put it, because putting down multiple layers of graphite creates shine, which will affect how your drawing is photographed. And here's the finished piece, Whipping in the Park. That's it. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Sara Millett, and if you want to hear more from me, sign up for my email list, linked below. When you do, you'll get a weekly update from me, which includes a progress photo of whatever it is I'm working on at the time, along with some links, and you get a one-time 10% discount off any purchase or commission. Also, as a reminder, there are still four prints of Butterfly in a Bush available. More info on how to buy down below. I'll see you all next week. Bye!